Guess I don't mind talking to you all now we opened up our histories.
I never really like did music. Like when I was in school, I kind of, me and my friends, we didn't listen to the music that I made or the music that I listened to at home. We didn't really listen to that. And so I think it was more like, what are my friends gonna think? And it's kind of me just like, yeah, really kind of just letting everyone know like what I'm actually about and what I actually want to do.
Knew I was falling, falling, falling. We were a perfect dream.
My name is Declan J Donovan. I'm a singer-songwriter from Essex. Probably like singer-songwriter pop. Kind of, it's all about the guitars, harmonies, and yeah, just kind of big choruses, I suppose. I kind of grew up with a lot of like early 2000s R&B, and then my brother kind of got me into like UK guitar bands, like the Maccabees or like the Kooks and Bombay Bicycle Club, people like that. And then, kind of like when I started secondary school, it was all about kind of UK rap and grime music, and that's all I listened to up until I still listen to it, but that was kind of like the first thing that I discovered on my own, where I was like, I actually love this. And then, yeah, that was all me and my friends used to listen to. And then I kind of just discovered all these singer-songwriters on YouTube, like Matt Corby and Ed Sheeran, people like that. And then thought I'd learn guitar. And then, yeah, realized that I just absolutely loved playing guitar, writing songs and singing. So yeah, it just kind of naturally happened. I had a guitar teacher for a few months, and then when it started getting a bit difficult, I kind of stopped. Once I learned like the basics, I was like, I can do it from here. I just loved singer-songwriter music and yeah, kind of stuff like that. But I never really told anyone that was the music I was into. So I just did it in my bedroom on my own. And then I studied music at college after finishing school. And yeah, and then just met kind of loads of people that just loved the same stuff as me. So it's kind of, that's what helped loads.
Tell me when it's alright. Going back to the start.
He was getting married probably 5 years ago now. And yeah, and then he asked me to be best man. And it was just that I started writing songs. And yeah, and then so I thought, instead of writing a speech about my brother, I thought I'd write a song about him and his wife now. About how they've been together since they were like 14, now they're in their 30s with a kid, another baby on the way. And yeah, so it's kind of just about them, kind of all their young love. Because it was only like the second song I ever wrote. So I think it was kind of written over like 2 or 3 weeks. Yeah, I think I finished it just before the wedding. Yeah, yeah, it kind of started like my whole career. No, I can't even remember writing the song. I've got like a video of it somewhere. And I think it's just like, get a good story, kind of plan it out in your head, and then kind of, yeah, I always kind of plan my songs by like, the verse is going to be about one thing, the pre-chorus is going to be about the next part of the story, the chorus kind of sums it all up, and then kind of go from there. So yeah, I think it's just kind of, yeah, just kind of start writing, see what comes out, see what you start singing, and yeah, kind of find a good story to write about. I think overall it's kind of like having a catchy song is what I try and do and make the lyrics kind of as universal as I can, where kind of someone will listen to it and be like, yeah, that actually happened to me once, like I can relate to that. And it's not making it too personal, which is like when I wrote the song Vienna about my mate Jack is standing behind the camera. So that was kind of, not many people kind of fall in love with someone from Vienna. So it was like kind of writing it in a way of like, it's kind of like a first love, but also happened in this specific place.
I got no more secrets, so now I'm on my way. Yes, I'm on my way to Vienna.
I'd probably work on a construction site with a few of my other mates from back home, probably. I was never really good at anything else, and I didn't really take school seriously. So, yeah, I probably wouldn't have been doing something in music, I don't think.